Howdy, folks, and welcome once more to Let's Stick Around in Escape from Tarkov today. Shoreline. For a moment, I forgot where we were. I don't know where we are on the map. We're on the east side. That's the eastern exit over there. Alright, so that explains why the tunnel is an option for the exit, so we gotta get to the other side of the map. Alright, cool beans, we're here. We got the same stuff as usual. The only new thing is I bought a CMS kit. Why? It can be used to treat wounds, and what this doesn't tell you is you can actually use this if one of your anything, except I think your head or your thorax, is actually destroyed. You can use that to fix it. So in my case, it's basically purely going to be for fixing if I get my stomach shot and destroyed. Feet, generally speaking, legs, I should say, I don't mind gimping around, like, painkillers and stuff, sure. But the stomach is a death sentence, and I figure that will help a little bit. We'll see. I bought those on the flea market, and I actually found 5 of 5 use ones for sale, and they were only, like, 10,000 rubles a piece, so I bought, I think, 5 of them. So, the system works. I want to say it was Arcurus who brought my attention to those. He's actually playing this on his channel as well, Arcurus Plays. Go ahead and give him a watch. His audio levels are a little bit low on his mic, but it's still perfectly watchable. And he is just getting started and becoming acquainted with the brutality of the AI mod. Some funny stuff. I don't know if I just saw a person over here. I might have. I might need to tone down the AI spawn multiplier, because I've noticed that, like, we have not been fighting, like, just a single AI, period, basically. And I wonder if that's because I set it to, like, AI per spawn 3 instead of 1. I assume it probably is, and I mean, I admittedly kind of like fighting enemies in groups, especially scavs. It makes them more, a little bit more of a threat than they would otherwise be. But with stuff like raiders? Man, that shit's scary. I don't know, we'll see. Okay, so this is the little radar area, I believe. Do I have a grenade? I do. Okay, making sure. Just making sure. There's no way there's nobody here. I'm not knowledgeable enough about, like, the spawn points. Can't tell if that's a scav, I don't think it is. I'm not knowledgeable about the spawn points on maps to be able to be like, oh, there's gonna be enemies here. I know, like, on some maps, like, I know, like, on Shoreline, for example, where, like, some of the sniper spawns are and stuff. Oh, that's a grenade. That's a grenade! Motherfucker throwing a fragmentation grenade at me. Another one. Also, I think there's like somebody in this building, maybe? Maybe not? I don't know. There's somebody. Ah, I see you. Oh, there's a leg. It begins. It begins. We're bleeding. Painkiller. I don't even want to know what that is. That sounds like a sharpshooter somewhere. I just need to come here for a moment. And is that light? That's light. Just bandage. I do need to be careful about the painkillers because hydration. We'll use a CMS kit. I don't know what this is actually gonna entail here. Okay, we can't move. Alright. We're suturing. There's snipping noises. Stapling. Alright. And look at that. Now we have one health on our leg. God mode acquired. Neat! So my thought is that the AI has probably forgotten about us, like they do. So I can probably reposition here. Try this from a different... I don't know where that sharpshooter is. It wouldn't surprise me if he was up there, though. Oh. Did I just... I did. Oh, it wasn't a sharpshooter. It was a guy with a shotgun. Okay. That a dude? Can't tell if person or body. Or just like random junk, as the case may be. Alright, what's up, friendo? Just gonna kinda take a second here to pick over your corpse. Ah, pump shotgun, Mossberg even. Yoink! Fancy shades! Don't mind if I do, those are fucking Ray-Bans. Good joke. Apple juice, nice, some hemostat. Was this guy... no, he wasn't a bear. Sabo rounds, these are actually, I don't think, great at all. No. Need AP for anything decent there. But, I mean... I wanna try the flechette rounds on a 12-gauge are supposedly... 5 penetration across the board, which might be worthwhile. I don't know. Do I really want to come over here? I mean, yeah. God damn it. We're here for loot. I can't just, like, wuss out of everything because I'm afraid of the bots. Is that? That is a body there. Holy shit. Alright. So I did get one of them. I didn't know that I killed. I probably shot him in the guts, maybe. And he died. I'll take it. Hello, weapon case. This is both energy and hydration on the milk. Very nice. Is that a 40mm? That is, in fact, a 40mm grenade round. These things tend to be actually quite valuable. Alright. Guys hiding anything else fun up here? Not looking like it. Okay, so... now... now is where I wish I had... like... a scope with better range on it. Like, even like a x3 magnification or something. Because, yeah, I could just sit up here and plink away. Because, like, there's probably a guy still out here. Oh, yeah, he bled out. Get shredded. Oh, man, the blood, fucking blood spatters all over the place. Nice. It is kind of cool that, like, you can drop dudes like that. Like, we saw that... God, what was the name of the episode? What did I end up calling it? I originally... its working title was Tank, but I changed it. It was the one where I ended up getting out of customs with, like, that crazy-ass, like, tier 6 body armor and helmet. And, like, we shot that one scab in the stomach, and he was, like, just sitting on the other side of a wall, like, wailing in pain before I domed him with the hand cannon. Hey, friend... ooh. SMG. Now mine. I did nail him in the torso. Okay, so this mag's empty, so I'm gonna pull that out. This thing. Can I? Oh, I totally can. No encumbrance! It's wonderful! I'm not carrying, like, loads of random shit. Is this heavy bleeding? Yes. Esmark, you're out. Hemostat, you're in. SMG, how you looking? Ammo? Full. 9x19 Quake Maker ammo. I... Have no idea. Let me unload a round. What is this? 9x19 Quake Maker. This is not on my decent ammo, and even 9x19's top shelf ammo isn't great. So this is full auto spray and pray. Hope we like nail him in the eyes type. Does it have no cool attachments? Anybody hiding in here? Wanna make friends? I'm gonna loot your toilet. No, nothing? Nothing. I mean, I'm not gonna complain for pomegranate juice. I suppose the shit's delicious. Oh my lord. Xenomorph, wiper fluid, a wrench, and a thermometer. Okay. Allow me to abscond to a corner here. So what do we got here? Hydration, energy 6. Hydration, energy 20. We are going to use the milk. Delicious meak! Bet you thought I couldn't find it this time of year. Those movies are better than they have any right to be, and anybody that disagrees is wrong. Okay. I would like to take this, but I also want the shotgun. See, this is the downside, is that my carrying capacity is like super limited. Goodbye, beautiful shotgun. Your sabo rounds will probably wither away to time, but oh well. Ooh, nice. More hemostat. I'm gonna leave the hemostat. This car med kit is actually fortuitous, because I'm sure it's been triggering people, but I've been running around with this injured leg. Might as well top up. Nice. So if I just like use this, will it heal everything? No. Okay. I have immunity. What does it mean? I don't know. And all their needs. There just needs to be a bot up here camping this stairwell. This would be horrifying, because like if you camped this room like right here, nobody's going to be able to come up these stairs without you seeing them do it. I mean, unless they rush the place, then I've talked about previously how Peeker's Advantage works in online games, but aside from that, stairwells are dangerous. Arma taught me that. And yeah, no joke. ₹700 isn't worth the inventory space. And I mean, we have all these things to search, but inventory's pretty well full, it looks like. How are we looking on carrying capacity's fine. Feels good, man. I don't know how people play like running around in T6 armor. Like that shit's crazy. Like it kills your stamina and you can't carry like fuck all. Alright. Take a peek in here. Get the fuck out. Ooh. What is this? Might be a gun right here. I bet it is. Fucking AKS. God damn it. A vector. Nope. Mount for sights. Sure. And a sound suppressor. Can't use it. There's a foregrip for an AR-15. I actually think we could use this, I believe, on our M2 or M4 rather, maybe. Nothing else though. And I'm taking the silencer solely because I bet it's probably worth some money. All right, let's get the fuck out of here. Outside of a little bit of busyness there in the beginning, this has been pretty tame so far. Glad I bought that CMS kit. Like, that thing's a fucking ass saver right there. You can also barter for them, but I don't know if we have merchants high enough level to do so. That would probably be the, like, superior way to acquire them. I'll have to look. I think it's therapist and maybe mechanic. It's either mechanic or Jaeger, maybe? Alright, so I think that's a gas station? This is coastline. Shoreline, if you will. Okay, so yeah, there's the hospital. Which, with increased bot spawns, is probably just a fucking killing field. I'm actually surprised, I'm being honest, at the lack of gunfire we've been hearing. Like, this has been downright silent outside of our little engagement there at the very beginning. I don't like it. Alright, lay down. Take a stamina break. That's good squishy. I don't even know where. Jesus fucking Christ, guys. Come on, man. If that sounded, like, close, but I have no idea. No idea where that came from. Suffice it to say, I want to be over here now. Because this way lies hard cover. I don't know if that was somebody up there or somebody in, like, the gas station. Because that's, like, two very different ways to approach an encounter. Again, I thought that was a body. It was not. Yeah, I don't know if there's somebody up there or what. I hate this crossing, by the way. This is terrible. Just fucking terrible. Ragdoll's pretty good, I will say. I don't know if that was that dude throwing a grenade, or if there's else, like, other people up there. I would assume that there are other people. Yeah, I don't believe for a second that dude was alone. He might have been. I just don't think he was. Hey, friendo! See, you weren't the dude that unloaded on me, I don't think. No, not with a VPO. Oh, key? Identified and paper. How big is this rig? How big is your rig? 3x3? I mean, technically. There were two of them. The other one went down the stairs. Woo. What'd your friend get off to? I hear him. Got him. Like, there are more of them up top, though. Like, this is numbers up there, and that I don't much care for. Yeah, that's a shotgun. Ow. Definitely a shotgun. God damn. Okay, what are we doing? Heavy bleeding? Let's go ahead and fix that again! The right leg. Why is it always the right leg? Why? Yeah. No. 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 Not yet. I just want to get my shit off that first dude, and we're gonna get the fuck out of here, I think. Hey, friendo. I've come back for my things. Give. Give. Back to hiding for a moment. Okay. Yeah. Get my arm. Okay. How are we looking? About half. Good enough for me. I gotta say, like, shotgun gonna shotgun, that nailed me from there. That's not unreasonable. Yeah. I don't know if I killed that dude. I'm going to work under the assumption that I did not. So that was what? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5? I dig it. I dig the increased spawn numbers. Because, like, really, scavs, like, individually aren't a huge threat. And, like, that's what I want them to be. I want PMCs and raiders to be incredibly dangerous, but also, like, very lucrative. And I think I may have hit that point now. We'll see. We'll have to see how things go going forward. But yeah, I think I'm about where I want to be difficulty-wise. Because essentially, like, we're a PMC, right? So we should be above scavs in the food chain. PMCs should be about on par with us. And then raiders are something everybody should be afraid of. So that works. Man, we're not gonna be able to go to Loot Island. There's totally a dude out there though. Two dudes, I don't even know what kind of range. I do not even know what kind of range that would be. Oh my God, I think I killed one of them, man. I'm good at video games. Fucking eyeballing that it's 150 meters. If we had a sight, like a scope on this thing, we'd have been fine, but now, of course, I'm going to be taking fire as we wuss our way out of here, but that's nobody's fault but my own. 5.56x45, M995, 885. Darn. I will take containers of bullets, and the power drill can stay. And I'm also going to medic my stomach. Mmm. Do I? Yeah, we've got apple juice and stuff here. Let me hydrate real quick. Drink that pomegranate juice. The superior juice. Delicious. Chew on the last of this painkiller. Yeah, start getting like some Vaseline instead. It's just wholly superior. The trick is going to be getting out of here alive, because I fully expect the opposition down here. And then across. Up this way. Oh my God, those fuckers are back out there. I want to shoot them so bad. But I mustn't. We must not make ourselves known if we can avoid it. He says, running down the road, yelping loudly as he does. We do have the SMG, but it is zeroed out to 25 meters. I might see if I can pull the sight off of it and replace this one with it. For this thing, I should get like a three times magnification optic for this thing, because this is more of like a, like, not a, it's a battle rifle. I think that's between like a close combat and like long range marksman rifle type thing. I can see about like fucking with the rails and we could get one of those cool side sights on it or something. No, and there's the limp. Just in time to make getting out of here a challenge. Got anybody fun up there? Not that I can see. That pleases me. At this point, I think I'm gonna swap over to this guy. Man, that jump. That gimp jump is something else. Alright. Yeah, Loot Island over there is probably going to be a bad time with the increased AI spawns. Because, like, that place was busy before the increased AI spawns, and now, like, I think that there could be, like, three or four guys over there by default, and if that triples that, man, you need to, like, lay siege to it. That or come in with, like, a long-range rifle and just pick them off from a distance, like what I was doing. Because I don't think the AI can really handle engagement at that range. Nothing in the trunk. Just keeping an eye out, you never know. Never know. This is always a bad extract to have in multiplayer, because this is like a PMC extract, and then right around this corner here is a scab extract. So like you come over here and it's just like a vicious fight, regardless. Nice. That wasn't too bad. I'll take it. A little noisome in the beginning, and a little bit in the middle there, but ended okay. 3,800, did we? Yeah, I think we did. I think we did snipe that dude. Didn't even get a distance on it. I wonder what that means. Holy shit. I wonder if that means I shot him in the thorax, now I was gonna say. And F1 thorax, leg. Oh, well, we killed one of those dudes, that first dude with the grenade where I winged that grenade out there. Nice, that actually did kill the one guy. Sweet. And here's the... trying to... So we killed the guy with the grenade. This was the one that was dead by that vehicle. I assume he bled out. And then this is the dude that had the shotgun that we came up on his side. Nice. And then, like, these four here, these are the gas station. And then, yeah, this would have had to have been that guy on the island. Did I hit him in the thorax and it didn't give me, like, a range on it? That leads me to believe that, much like this dude right here, it wasn't the initial shot that killed him, but he probably bled out as well. Which, as I've mentioned before, I think is just a really cool mechanic that applies to bots as well. Especially with how lethal bleeding damage is in this, so. Works for me. Time to see how much blood money we've earned, I suppose. Weren't really furthering any of our goals there. I gotta get back to working on mission objectives, but one day, one day. One round left in this mag, five in the other one. Very nice. Okay, so can I pull this off? Can I put this thing on my... I can. Nice. Okay. Just unload this ammo. What is this? 9x18. I have it specifically listed that 9x18 has no good ammo types in this game. Nice. 545x39. PRS ammo is not on the win list, so it gets vendored. FAL. This is, I think, I've just had it sitting in here. That can go, that can go. This thing is like sharp as hell, but I bet it's worth a bunch of money, so we're gonna sell it. And this guy, can I pull this off? Then if I pull this, no. Yeah, then we can put this on, and this will let me put like all kinds of like crazy shit on this thing, I bet, if I want to. But we can get this guy on there, which is a closer range optic, I think probably more in line with what I am going to be using this rifle for. I should get like a 3x optic on this thing, but I'm bad, so I won't. Apple juice, you can stay. You're in. Blessed hydration. What do I need? We need ammo. These M80 rounds. They're fucking expensive, but they are doing work. So they can stick around as well. Let's see, what do I need? Can we get, like, can I get Vaseline? Therapist, do you barter for it or anything? No. No, you don't. My disappointment is great. I'm sure she might at higher levels. But she does not now. Fence, you got anything cool for cheap? What the fuck? Oh, it's the mega bag. Yeah, I'll pass on that. Just the ice pick. A crash axe. Alright. Got some keys. And a bunch of other stuff. Ooh, F1 hand grenades. Yeah. I'm buying those. I like grenades. Scopes worth 36 grand, not bad. 230,000, I believe 50 of it on explosives, but that works for me. Here we go. I do like the F1 hand grenades. They work well by me, so I like having extras for cheap. Okay, I want to check here really quick. Got Vaseline. I think I probably spelled it wrong. Is it with an E? Oh, no, it's... Oh, it is with an E. Ha! Got any full use ones? 1 of 6, 2 of 6. Nice! 58,000 for 2 of 6. Fucking get screwed. That's pretty great. In that case, I will just pull some painkillers. Alright, let's see, is there anything else I need? No, not really. I want to look. Night vision scope. Oh, and it takes a drill. God damn it, I should have taken that drill. I would never use it, of course, but... Tactical flashlight with a laser. Can't put it on shit. Peacekeeper? I need to start selling stuff to peace. Like, we're almost there. Can I buy, like... I need to buy, like $2,000. Oh, it hurts us, precious. Right in my dollary dues. Oh, there we go. Leveled Peacekeeper up. Jesus. Oh, we can barter for some M67 grenades. That's nice. What is this? I mean, we need the dollars anyways. Can I actually, like... Can I sell dollars? No. That would be interesting. That would be like such a way to fucking just cheese. earning his faction, but that's okay. Now we've got, wow, holy shit. His inventory really opened up. AC4 helmet, really? That's good, it's got mounts on it too. Alright. Looks like this, he's actually got some pretty decent stuff for sale here. What is this? Oh, the M1911. I love this handgun so much. Oh, let's see what else we got. Anything fun? What is this? 4x30 scope. Oh my lord. A Walther MRS reflex sight. Alright. Well, he's got just a bunch of shit. I will go through. That's actually kind of cool that you can actually sort it by what rank you unlocked here. Very nice. I will go through and identify all of this stuff between episodes just so that I know kind of what I've got to work with. But I do think that I'm going to go ahead and call it here. So as usual, folks, thank you for watching. I hope you had a good time. And I will see you all next time where in Survival Continues. Until then.